Students, our today's lecture is on halides and oxo acids of alkali metals. The alkali metals, which we have told you, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, they react with halogens X2, where X2 can be X is FCl, Br or I. They react with halogens to form halides. M plus X minus. These halides are ionic compounds. They are white, they are crystalline and have high melting point. The important point here is that once you can see that M plus means they have lost the electron, therefore they are colorless. They are colorless. There is no electron which is present in the metal ion. After it has lost one electron, it attains stable inert gas configuration. Now, how to prepare it? One of the simplest thing is you react metal with X2 and you will get metal halides. So when we react with halogens, what is happening? You can get metal halides which are ionic in nature. Further, you will see that the reaction rate increases down the group, because as you go from lithium to cesium, the ionization enthalpy decreases. Therefore, with the decrease in ionization enthalpy, it is going to be more easy to form. The cesium is larger in size, it is more easy to be formed cesium halides because of the lower ionization enthalpy as we go down the group. And for halogens, for the same metal, the order of reactivity will be F greater than Cl, greater than Br, greater than I, because fluorine is the most electronegative. Since we are forming ionic compounds, the fluorine, the halide has to accept electrons from the metal. Therefore, the more electronegative the element, the more oxidizing the element, the more easily it will be formed. So the order of reactivity is this. Further, we can also prepare them from oxides preparation, from oxides, hydroxides and carbonates of metal, alkali metals. So what we are trying to show you, that if I take M2O, for example lithium oxide, and I react with hydrogen acids, hydrogen halides, these are our hydrogen halides. So if I react with HCl, what is the result of this? You will get lithium chloride and H2O. So if I take Na2O2 sodium oxide, sodium, what will be the result if I react with HCl? So you will get and H2O. So we can prepare from oxides, we can also prepare from hydroxides. If I take hydroxide and react with HX, then what is going to happen? NaOH plus HCl give you what? NaCl plus H2O. If I take carbonates and react with HCl, what is the result of this? You will get NaCl H2O plus CO2. So we can prepare them from oxides, from hydroxides, from carbonates also. The important point to remember is that, and the most important questions which are coming from this, is the enthalpies of formation of halides. What is the meaning of enthalpy of formation? We are talking of delta FH0 values for the formation of the halide. That means when I am reacting M gas reacting with X minus, I am forming MXS. There is a release in energy. There is a heat is being released. So we are talking of delta F0 values. So during this process, the heat is evolved and they are having more energy. Heat is given out. This becomes more stable. The more the heat evolved, more stable is the halide. More the delta H F negative, more stable is the halide. So the negative value more, that means the more heat is evolved, more stability is there, more lattice enthalpy is there. So more lattice enthalpy. We already know what is lattice enthalpy, the energy which must be supplied to break one mole of the solid substance into gaseous constituent ion is our lattice enthalpy. So what are the trends here for fluorides? For fluoride, I take lithium fluoride, sodium fluoride, lithium potassium fluoride, rubidium fluoride, cesium fluoride. The delta F0H becomes more as you go down the group. As you go down the group, this is fluoride is smaller, this is smaller. As the size will increase, this will become less negative. So down the group, what is happening, student? This is becoming less negative. This value is less negative. This is less stable. Less stable. Why? Because F minus is smallest and has a high intense negative charge. So it is likely to be stabilized more with the smallest cation, which is lithium plus. So lithium plus is smallest fluoride and fluoride. There is a very strong force of attraction between the two. The lattice enthalpy of LIF is the highest. This will have very highest lattice enthalpy. And it is, in fact, that's what we are saying, it is the most stable. And it is not, that is why it is the least soluble. And you will see that lithium fluoride has a least solubility because of high lattice enthalpy, because this is very smallest F minus is the also the smallest halide, and there is a strong attractive force between the two. It is very difficult to break this. Hence, lithium fluoride has the highest lattice enthalpy. And as you are going down the group, they are becoming less stable, we are saying. And the lattice enthalpy is decreasing. Then, in the case of fluoride, this is the values of the delta F0 for the formation of this. But the trend is reversed when we change the halide. Very important point. That if I take X is Cl, Br or I, delta FH0 is trend reversed due to large size of X minus. So this will be stabilized with larger M plus. So what happens if I take lithium chloride, sodium chloride, potassium chloride, rubidium chloride and cesium chloride? The delta FH0 values will increase. There will be an increase negative value of delta FH0 down the group. So the negative value increases for the formation of the enthalpies. As for the Cl, Br or I, because they are larger anions, will stabilize more with the larger cation. And if I take the same metal then and change the halide X, then what is the result of this? If I take lithium chloride, then I take lithium bromide, lithium chloride bromide, lithium iodide, and you have lithium fluoride. If I take lithium fluoride,
Now here the lattice enthalpy, or here what is the delta F0 H value, delta F H0 value for fluorides will be more than Cl, will be more than Br, will be more than I. If these are the same, this is the order it will follow. Because you are taking the same cation, but the F minus has more intense charge. There is a more attractive force between F minus as compared to Cl, Br and I. So these are some of the values of enthalpies of formation, questions of which are usually given in exam, and they are very important questions, students. So what we find that these halides, which we have told you, they have high melting point. They have high melting point because they are ionic. They are ionic. Ionic. And as you can see that M plus, if I take X minus, so what will happen if you take M plus F minus, M plus Cl minus, M plus Br minus, M plus I minus. So this you can see that smaller cation and smaller anion, the lattice enthalpy will be higher. Lattice enthalpy higher. And as I said that lithium fluoride is the least soluble. Least soluble. And also the melting point are decreasing down the group. Because the lattice enthalpy is decreasing because of the increase in size of the cation, there is a decrease in the melting point and there is solubility. These halides are generally soluble. These halides are generally soluble in water. But lithium fluoride least soluble due to high lattice enthalpy. And another one, cesium iodide also has low solubility in water. In water, due to here the reason is the lower hydration enthalpy of cesium plus. Students, what you already know, when we will dissolve anything in water, the solubility will be decided by two things. One is the lattice enthalpy and second is the hydration enthalpy. Whenever you are putting a substance in water, you have to supply energy equal to lattice enthalpy to break these ions apart. After that, these ions get hydrated and they release energy. If the hydration enthalpy is high, then it can become soluble. It depends on these two factors. And here you see the lithium fluoride. Lithium fluoride is less soluble because its lattice enthalpy is very large. Positive ion, negative ion, very small, and intense attractive force between the two. And they are bound and strongly together. So very difficult to break by the water this attractive force which is existing between small lithium ion and intense charge of the fluoride ion. But this size is bigger, so this has a lower lattice enthalpy. But the hydration further you see that the hydration enthalpy is important also. The hydration enthalpy of cesium is very less, so it is not able to compensate or supply that much energy which is required for breaking cesium into cesium plus and I minus I. So here it is not the lattice enthalpy, here it is the lower value of the hydration enthalpy which is responsible for the low solubility of cesium iodide. This question has been asked many times. It is very important because you will see that lithium chloride or lithium halides are having covalent character. They have some covalent character. Why? Because of the lithium ion, you know the polarization which is discussed in Fajan's rule. The lithium ion is the smallest, so it polarizes the anion more as compared to the other ones. So the lithium halides are, will show covalent character, whereas all others are ionic in nature. This is about the halides. Let us see something about the oxoacids. Oxoacids. What are oxoacids? First of all, what are oxoacids, students? That means you have an OH group in which H plus is ionizable. Ionizable mean acidic. Acidic. Then you have oxo group. What is oxo group? For example, C double bond O, S double bond O, or P double bond O. So oxygen is bound with the element with a double bond. Double bond. This is called oxo. So if you have oxoacids like H2CO3 is oxoacid. H2CO3 is oxoacid. You can have H2SO4, you can have HNO3, you can have HNO2, or you can have H3PO4. They are all examples of the oxoacids. Here we are going to talk about carbonates, students. You know the structure of carbonate, but I am saying C double bond OH. So this is our H2CO3. This is the oxo group. These are two ionizable OH, as I said. They have two H which can be donated. So what will can be the result of this? This H2CO3 can react with the metals to form what? But they will form Na2CO3. They can form Na2CO3. And also, if I react with NaOH, what is the result? Na2CO3, and you are getting H2O. Similarly, you can also form NaHCO3. So you can form carbonates, and you can form hydrogen carbonate. Hydrogen carbonate. So carbonate and hydrogen carbonates can be formed by, and also, for example, other oxoacids which we have told you could be. So Na2OCO3, NaHCO3, Na2SO4, and NaHSO4. These are all examples of the oxoacids, because they can easily, they can react with oxoacids, and these alkali metal hydroxides, they are basic, so they can react with oxoacids to form salt and water. So we can get these hydrocarbonates. They are solids compounds, and they are thermally stable. The exception is lithium carbonate is not stable because it dissociates to form lithium oxide and carbon dioxide. What is the reason for this? You know that lithium ion is a smaller cation, and carbonate is larger anion. Hence, smaller cation is not able to stabilize with the larger anion. Therefore, lithium carbonate is unstable. It will dissociate to give lithium oxide and carbon dioxide. And LiHCO3 does not exist in solid form. So these are the things. Lithium is an exception. It is not existing. Li does not exist due to the smaller size of lithium, because the size of lithium is very small. It is not existing, and this is thermally unstable, which is lithium carbonate. It will dissociate. Most of the times you will see they are white crystalline solids and are soluble in water, and you will find that further you will see the stability. When I talk about the stability of carbonates, what will be, as you go down the group, what is happening, down the group, size of M
increasing. Basicity increasing. And therefore the stability also increased down the globe. So they will become more and more stable as you go down the group, because electropositive character increases. Electropositive character increases. Alright students, this is the end of this topic. We will meet you in our next class. Okay.